Well, the parenting practices are very highly predictive of teen mental health, but then they also have very important indirect effects on teen mental health through the quality of the relationship overall. So we assess the overall quality of the relationship between teens and parents using several items. One, we ask the teens on a 0 to 10 scale, where 10 is the most loving and supportive relationship you can imagine, 0 is the worst. How do you rate your parents? And we also ask the parent who responded to the survey, what's your overall quality of relationship with your child? We asked other items like to what extent they argue, to what extent there's conflict and that sort of thing. Pull all those together, that those items are very predictive of adolescent mental health. And
I see.
the parenting practices are very predictive of those, relationship outcomes. And that's where most of the benefit seems to come from. There's some direct effects of the demandingness directly on youth mental health. But when you have them in the same model, it's more in predicting that high quality relationship, and that having that secure, loving relationship is what, and without conflict, without frequent conflict and so on, is what seems to really be driving youth mental health. And we considered many other variables and subsequent analysis that wasn't published in this piece that could predict youth mental health, even the extent that they're bullied in school, how they get along with their peers, and the quality of the relationship with their parents was dominant. And that was is very, very important. There's no doubt about it. And to put it in quantitative terms, we in this paper I'm doing with Telly Davuti, my colleague at Gallup, we find that 36% of variation in youth mental health can be explained by parenting practices and the quality of the parent-child relationship.